Hey, Ronnie, you just flew in from Las Vegas.
Boy, are my arms tired.
I knew you were going to do the oldest freaking joke in the whole world.
You can't drop me that line without expecting it.
I set you up. The SEMA Show. Ronnie was there. He's going to tell us about it next on Men Are So Smart. So, if you're a car guy or a car girl, the SEMA Show, held annually in Las Vegas, is the place to be. And so, in an effort to bring you the very latest in automotive news, etc., Ronnie attended the show.
I did.
When were you there? Which days?
We got there Monday evening, and we went Tuesday and Wednesday, and then the show closes on Friday, is the last day. But we went 2 days. It's so massive. We walked 9 hours through the show on Tuesday and 8 hours on Wednesday. And saw a lot, but not everything. These halls that they have it in are so huge. You take the Sacramento Convention Center, about four of those make up one building. And there are five buildings here that you're going to go through. And a couple of them have upper and lower levels. Mm-hmm. So it's enormous. Every kind of accessory you could ever put on a car, the manufacturers are at SEMA, and they're showing their wares. Basically, one whole building is nothing but wheels and tires. Mm-hmm. They had one that was body equipment. So if you're in the body repair business, it's spray booths, it's guns, it's compressors. The show is great because almost every booth has a live demonstration going, like wraps. They put wraps on cars now instead of paint. They had probably no fewer than 250 different vendors of wraps. And they can do the most amazing things with wraps. They had a McLaren and a Bugatti, so both $700,000 plus cars. And they had wrapped them with this wrap called Expel. And then they take a wire brush. They scratch the wrap. Once it's scratched, it's like, well, now what do? You put a little water on it, and the thing self-heals.
It grows back.
It's as good as new.
Wow.
You dry it off, and you are unable to see any scratches in there.
How is that even possible?
It's science! I don't know. It really is. It's remarkable. The biggest thing for me, though, was all the celebrities. I'm a big fan of the Velocity Channel.
Oh, yeah, I know you are.
And I'm not sure if they sponsored this, but they sure had a lot of their people out there and about. It's never hard finding the celebrities because there's a gigantic group of people standing around, craning their head, trying to get a view. Mm-hmm. It was Christy Lee.
Oh, she's one of your favorites. I know
she is. I love
her.
She's so wonderful. And you know what? She knows cars. She races motorcycles.
I know.
She was on All Girls Garage.
Right.
She's a spokesman on Barrett Jackson Auctions. She's like a straight dude, but she's good looking.
Yes, she is.
Yeah. She was interviewing Ryan Friedlinghaus, who is from West Coast Customs.
Oh, okay.
And he does some of the most over-the-top custom builds. He's a lot like Dave Kindig, who I also saw out there from Kindig Customs. I was the most starstruck with Goldberg.
Oh, the wrestler.
The wrestler.
Yeah, what's he up to?
About 6'4", 260 pounds, I'd say.
Okay.
He was wearing a t-shirt. It was like a second skin, and you could count his abs through that t-shirt. These deltoid muscles, of which mine are... I'm resting them right now. They're resting.
Yeah.
His, it's almost like they start right about his earlobes, and they go down. That shirt really was... probably about three sizes too small, but it looked good on him. And when I look at him, it's like looking in a mirror.
Well, they wanted you to do body double for him, didn't they?
They did.
I don't make these things up.
The show, like I said, it's overwhelming because there's a lot of new products out there. They're only new for a minute, and then 50 people are also doing the same similar thing. One of them we saw that was really great, we ended up talking to the Escort people that do the radar detectors and laser detectors. So if you're like in a car and you're afraid and you like to speed, you might spend a little money and get yourself an Escort brand detector. Well, being in law enforcement, I know that the LIDAR, which is the laser type of radar detector, is undetectable. We see a car coming that looks like it's speeding, we wait, and then we pull the trigger, and then at that second, they're busted. We get the speed reading, and we know how fast they're going. So there's really no way to combat that. The second that they get somebody's shooting LIDAR at me, it's too late. We've already got the reading. So I asked them kind of how they dealt with that, and they sell a scrambler. And it's only legal in 34 states, and California is not one of them.
Of course not.
But
that's where we shoot the show.
Yes. I asked him, and he said, yeah, it's not legal in California. But what it does is they put little sensors right up by your license plate, because that's typically what we aim for, and it shoots back a signal that the LIDAR can't understand. And so as they squeeze the trigger, they get gibberish on their screen. And what do? They just go to the next car. They're not inexpensive. He said it starts at about $850 for the scrambling technology.
Wow.
Yeah.
So what would you say was the most innovative thing you saw?
You know, I would have to say that self-healing wrap. I went to their website. It's not inexpensive, but it's not crazy expensive. I'm probably going to spend about $100 and get some, and I'm going to put it right up near the top of my bed on my truck, because it seems like whenever I wash it, I drag the hose up there and I get these tiny little microscopic scratches. So I'm going to rub it all out, and then put the Expel just around that. To wrap my whole car would be unbelievably cost prohibitive for me, at least. And we have a friend who was at this show, and he said that he knows that wrapping a car is about a $6,000 venture. It's not for the faint of heart or faint of pocketbook. Mm-hmm. He said he does a lot of basketball players' cars.
Yeah.
But the great thing is, when you get sick of the color, you peel it off, you take it back in, and then they redo it in a different color.
Now, I understand you're quite the rapper.
It's a different kind of rapping.
Oh, you weren't talking about that?
No.
Oh, I wasn't listening. I'm sorry.
Yeah. I rap Christmas presents. It's about the only thing I rap anymore.
Yeah.
And I do it pretty well.
So you have a Christmas rap.
Yes.
Well, let's hear it.
The only other thing I'll throw out there about SEMA is it's not for Joe consumer. Let's say the next year you had a little extra money, you wanted to go to SEMA, you fly down to Las Vegas. You can't buy an admission. It's a trade show. And so you have to own a business, operate a business, you know, manage a business, or be an employee of the business. Each business gets so many badges. I was kind of snuck in there on a pass. It's unfortunate that everybody can't go in there, because it was truly over the top amazing. The downside is there were 160,000 people at this show.
Holy cow.
And so literally the whole day you're doing this with people. And we discovered that the area of the building we were in, we needed to be in the opposite corner to get on a shuttle to take us back to our hotel. And it took us 15 minutes
to get through the crowd,
to cut through the crowd. And we took cut right straight down through the middle, the most direct route. And it was still 15 minutes bumping shoulders, running into people. And
I don't think I could do it
wrong. Yeah, that might be a little bit over the top for you.
Yeah.
But it would be over the top for almost anybody,
but you know what? Maybe if we just had a booth and we did our show from there.
True enough. You know what? I'll check into that. They were doing lots of live broadcasting from there. A lot of my favorite shows. Wheeler's Dealers. I think his name is Mike Brewer. He was on there. Guy from Graveyard Cars, Mark Warman, was there. He actually got an award for forwarding the Mopar brand. He's a gigantic Mopar expert. He does amazing things with old Mopars. He restores not just any Mopar, but, you know, 69, 70, 71 ish, yeah. The very classic, you know, Challengers, Cudas, Chargers, what have you. Mm-hmm. I was a little bit starstruck at some of them. It was kind of an over the top show.
But you didn't see Jesse Combs, my friend.
As hard as I looked, she was there.
Yeah.
Because I follow her on Twitter. You could put in the hashtag SEMA17 and you could see people that were there and find out where they were. I just could not catch up with her. And so it didn't work out. I would have loved to got anything autographed by her. So
she's a cool chick.
She is amazing.
Yep.
Yeah. Pretty amazing.
Okay. So the very latest from the SEMA show 2017 in Las Vegas.
Yes.
Ronnie bringing us all the special news and new stuff. if you did enjoy the show, I hope you did, like it, okay? Just click that thumbs up button. We'd appreciate that. Also, subscribe to the channel. It's a way for you to get away from the seriousness of the world. You know, it's a tongue-in-cheek show.
Which is kind of hard to talk that way, by the way.
My man's so smart. So it's not that hard. So, in any case, thank you for watching. That subscribe button should drop in about just about any second. Right? All the information you'll find below in the description. And we will see you next time on Men Are So Smart. Thanks for watching.